I want to show you how easy it has become to deal with null in PHP. Null has always been this kind of burden. Whenever something can be nullable, you'll have to write extra checks to make sure that your code doesn't break. I talked about one way of dealing with null in the past by using the null object pattern. But today I want to show you how PHP itself has evolved in dealing with null. We'll have to start way back in PHP 4. That's when two important functions were added, isset and unset. Isset checks whether a value is null or whether it doesn't exist, and in both cases it will return false. Unset takes a variable and removes it. That means there is a distinction between something being null and something not existing at all, and it's going to be important later in this video. Fast forward to PHP 7.0, where we got null coalescing, one of the best operators ever to be added in PHP, if I can say so myself. Previously, we had to write checks to prevent unexpected null values, but now we can use the null coalescing operator to provide a fallback value when something is null. You can even use it for object properties and arrays, including nested values and including values that don't exist. With PHP 7.1, we got nullable types, meaning we can now write code that is much more explicit in telling whether we're dealing with null, or perhaps even better, when null is not allowed. PHP 7.4 introduced the null coalescing assignment operator, which does exactly the same as the null coalescing operator, but it will also write the value back if it didn't exist before. On top of that, type properties were added. And here's an important distinction. There's a difference between a property with a value of null and a property that hasn't gotten a value yet. A nullable property can either be null or, in this case, an array. But on the other hand, an uninitialized property doesn't necessarily need to be nullable. It simply hasn't gotten a value yet, or its value could have been unset. Luckily, PHP will tell you about uninitialized properties if you try to use them. But you have to keep in mind that if you want nullable type properties, you'll have to provide a default null value to initialize them, because PHP won't magically do that for you. Moving on, PHP 8.0 introduced the Nullsafe operator. It's kind of similar to null coalescing, but at the same time it's not. The Nullsafe operator is used to call methods on objects that might be null. If the object in question is null, the Nullsafe operator will simply return null instead of throwing an error. So while null coalescing is meant to read data from objects and variables, the Nullsafe operator is used to call methods on variables that might be null without PHP throwing an error. Finally, there's PHP 8.2, which introduced the standalone null type. It probably won't be widely used, but it can be interesting in, for example, applying the null object pattern. I think it's great to see so much syntax for dealing with null in PHP these days. But what about you? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Leave a like, subscribe, you know what to do, and I will see you in the next video.